The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 4th chapter, text number 20, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on April 9th, 1974, in Bombay, India.
Translation. Abandoning all attachment to the results of his activity, ever satisfied and independent, he performs no fruitive action, although engaged in all kinds of undertakings.
Tattva karma phala sanga nitya tvita nirashaya karmani abhi pravittopi na eva kinchit karoti sa. So, tattva karma phala sanga. This is a very difficult task. Everyone is expecting some result for his personal benefit. How much I have gained by this business? That is our disease. Everyone. Idam adya maya labdham, idam prache punadhanam. All the people of the world, they're struggling hard for existence, simply calculating that this much I have achieved today and this much I will achieve tomorrow. In this way, my bank balance will be increased more and more. That is very much explained in the 16th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, Asuri. Pravittincha, nivittincha, nabidu asuro jana. Asuro jana. Just find out page 16 chat. Asuro jana. Asurik jo hai. Asurik ka arth hota hai. I haven't come to you. Asurik means non-devotees. Atheist. Asurik. What is the page? What is page number? So, in the 16th chapter, it has been explained that what is the difference between atheist and theist, or persons with God consciousness and persons without God consciousness. It is said, do bhutasargo loke asmin daiva asura evach. Daivi sampa, daivi vistarasa prokta asuram patha me sinu. Krishna is explaining that there are two classes of men, loke, in every place or every planet. Some planets are full of asuras. They are called asura loka. And another place it is said that who are the asuras and who are the devas? Vishnu bhakta bhavet deva asurastad viparaya. There are many demigods. The demigods worshippers are also demons. Only Vishnu bhakta bhavet deva. Vishnu bhakta. Those who are devotees of the Supreme Lord, personality of God, Vishnu. Om Tad Vishnu Paramam Padam Sadapasanti Suraya. This is Rig Veda mantra. Suraya and Asuraya. Those who are Suraya, Devas, Devidas, they are simply worshipping Tad Vishnu Paramam Padam, the Supreme Personality of God. Rasurasta viparya. And asura means just opposite. opposite number means those who are not interested in Vishnu worship. Nate vidu sartha gati ni Vishnu. They do not know that ultimate goal of life to approach Vishnu, Lord Vishnu, the Supreme Personality of God. So, asuras, they are engaged for fruitive results. They are working, but they are expecting that I shall enjoy the result. So, that freedom is given to everyone, that you can work at your responsibility and enjoy or suffer. Just like state has given everyone individuality, everyone freedom, you act as you like. But if you act criminally, then you will be punished. That you cannot avoid. You have been given freedom, you act whatever you like. But if you violate the laws of the state, then you are to be punished, criminal. Similarly, the same thing is there in God's kingdom, that we have been given freedom. We have got little freedom because we are part and parcel of God. Mami imamsa jiva-bhuta. So Krishna says, all these living entities, they are my minute particles, minute part of my body. Just like father is the part of the body, son is the part of the body of father. Similarly, we are also part and parcel of the transcendental body of Krishna. That is our real identity. His spiritual identity. So therefore, Krishna has got freedom, full freedom. So we have got also freedom in minute quantity. That is our position. That freedom, if we use properly, then we are happy. And if we misuse improperly, then we are unhappy. But freedom is there. Krishna says that sarva-dhanmān parityajya māmekaṁ saranaṁ braja. He is requested, Arjuna, that he just surrender unto me. He is all-powerful. He can force anyone and everyone to be surrendered to him. But that has no do. That is not Krishna's business. He gives freedom because Krishna has given me little freedom. So, he does not want to interfere with your freedom. Then what is the meaning of giving freedom? That is Krishna's wish. Jate chasi tatha kuru. Krishna says, Arjuna, now I have explained to you the whole Bhagavad Gita. Now, what is your decision? You can do whatever you like. Because Krishna, Arjuna's decision was, that I shall not fight. I am not going to kill my brothers and nephews and teachers and grandfather. Krishna, excuse me. I will not fight. So, therefore, Krishna instructed him the whole Bhagavad Gita, science. Now, after hearing Bhagavad Gita, he asked, because he has got the freedom. Now, what is your decision? Jate chasi tatha kuru. Whatever you like, you can do. You can reject my proposal, or you can accept. This is freedom. Then Krishna, Arjuna said, yes, Krishna vachanam tavo, I shall accept your proposal. This is Krishna consciousness. Krishna is giving instruction to everyone. This is the way of life, to come gradually to Krishna consciousness. All these things are being explained by Krishna. How to work, how to gradually come to Krishna consciousness, because Krishna consciousness is the original consciousness. Now it is polluted. Just like originally, when the rain falls, it is pure distilled water. And as soon as it touches the ground, it becomes polluted. Immediately dirty. Similarly, as spirit soul, we are pure. As Krishna is pure, Krishna is explained in the 10th chapter. Parabrahma paramadhama pavitram paramam bhava purusam shasatam nityam. So, pavitram paramam bhava. Krishna is param pavitra, complete pure. And we are part and parcel of Krishna, we are also pure. That is our real identity. We are pure. But we have been contaminated by the touch of this material world. The same example, the rain falls, it is pure distilled water. But when it touches the surface of the earth, it becomes dirty. Therefore we see the rivers full of dirty water. That is not the water is dirty, but because it is mixed up with the dirty dots of the surface of the globe, so we fall down. When we deny to accept Krishna as the Supreme, or we try to imitate Krishna, now why Krishna shall enjoy? We shall also enjoy. Why Krishna shall have last dance? We shall also last dance. Why Krishna will marry 16,000 wives? We shall marry at least 16 wives. When this competitive spirit comes, then we fall down. Fall down means Krishna gives the chance. All right, you also go. You also dance in the hotel, ball dance, and be complicated. Because he does not know what is last dance, he imitates ball dance. So everything what is going on in this material world, it is imitation of Krishna's activities. Janmadasyajata, the Vedanta Sutra says. Everything that is going on, it is simply generated from that original. So, but it is contaminated. Because in touch with the material, three qualities. Some of them are goodness, some of them are passion, and some of them are ignorance. The example is given, just like fire, big fire, and the sparks are coming out from the fire, that is natural. Similarly, the big fire is Krishna, and we are small sparks. So, the sparks sometimes fall down from the original fire, fall down. So, falls down, when the fire sparks falls down on the dry grass, it creates fire. And if it is fallen down on the land, it keeps the fiery element for some time. But if it falls down on the water, immediately it is extinguished. Similarly, when we fall down from Krishna's association, the fire, big fire and the spark, if we be in touch with the modes of goodness, then we keep some Krishna consciousness. Just like the Brahmanas, the quality of Satya Samadhamma Titi. And if we fall down on the ground, then we keep sometimes the fiery quality. That is passion. Three qualities, the goodness and passion. And if we fall down in the ignorance, just like the spark falls down on the water, then it is extinguished. No Krishna consciousness. Finish. But it can be revived. That is explained in the Prem Vivarta. Krishna bhuliya jeev bhogavancha kare pasate mayatare japotiya dhore. As soon as we want to imitate, even in the material world, those who are trying to go up again, back to home, back to Godhead, there are different processes. Karma, Jnana, Yoga. Krishna is explaining the karma. How to go back again to the original consciousness, that is being described, karma. How to work? So, even those who are trying for that, because that original disease is there, therefore, even one who has advanced spiritually, he also says, I am God. The same spirit, to make competition with Krishna. The Maya is there. Why you are going to worship Krishna? You are God. Oh yes, I am God. This is the last layer of Maya. Therefore they are Mayavadis. Nobody can become Krishna. Krishna says, matta parataram nanya kinti jasti dhananjaya. Nobody can be equal to Krishna. Nobody can be greater than Krishna. Then what is the meaning of God? If there are so many irrational gods, then what is the specific personality of God? So this is the last snare of Maya. If one is trying to become God, that is not possible. That is Asuri. Asuri bhava-māsrita. Krishna's desire is that you surrender. Sarva-dharmān, you have manufactured so many things within this material world to become happy. This is all foolishness. You will never be happy. That was Krishna says. Because Krishna loves, he is sarva-dharmān parityajamāmekam sarvanjaya. But the Maya says, no, why? You become Krishna. You become God. This is going on. This is Asuri. Asuri bhava. So it is very difficult to give up the Asuri bhava. Namāna diskitunam mūrhā prapadnante marādhamā. Maya parityajamāna Asuri bhava-māsrita. On the basis of Asuri bhava, one is always constantly engaged in duskriti, sinful activities, and mura, falsely thinking that he is God. Therefore, he is a mura. That is a sign, a big mura. Small muras, they are working hard only to become happy. And the big mura, he wants to become God. The small mura wants to become a minister or a president, and the big mura wants to become God. The disease is the same. I shall become the most powerful. But that is not possible. Therefore, these big muras who simply falsely thinking that I have become now liberated by meditation or by some jugglery of power. So they have been described in the Bhagavad as vimukta manino. They are falsely thinking that they have become liberated. They have become Narayan. How you can become Narayan? This pastor says, jastu nārāyaṇam devam brahma-rudrādi daivatavi samaktena vikheta sapāṣaṇḍī bhavedhruvam. Nārāyaṇam devam. Even Śaṅkarācārya, he says, nārāyaṇam bhaktyā para. Nārāyaṇam is transcendental. He has nothing to do with this material. So Vaiṣṇavas also say, jastu nārāyaṇam devam brahma-rudrādi daivatavi. Brahma, Lord Brahma and Lord Shiva, they are demigods of this material world. So, if one puts Narayana even with the level of Brahma and Rudra, Lord Shiva and Lord Brahma, they are the very exalted, big demigods. Lord Shiva is almost like Narayana. Narayana is 95% complete God and Lord Shiva is 85%. And Krishna is 10%. There is analysis. Just Narayana Devam Brahma Rudra Adi Devata Samatena Vikheta Samatena Equal. Well, whatever is Narayana, there is also Lord Shiva, there is also Lord Brahma, there is also Goddess Kali. This is Mayavad. Because Mayavad philosophy is that the absolute truth is impersonal. That is the final understanding. So, because we cannot think of impersonal, meditate upon that, let us imagine some form. Sadhakanam hitarthaya brahmana rupa kalpana. The Mayavadi philosopher, they say, that kalpana, you just imagine any form. Therefore, they especially recommend the five forms. the five forms, the Surya, Sun God, Ganesh, and Durga, Vishnu and Lord Shiva. There is also Vishnu. But this Vishnu and the Vaishnava consciousness of Vishnu is different. This Vishnu is imagination. And Vaishnava conception of Vishnu is reality. Krishna is reality. Abhijananti māna mūrha māna santanu āsa. Buddha and mūrha, the same mūrha. Because he has come in the form of a human being. They say this is Maya. This Krishna has come. The impersonal Brahma has assumed a body, accepting this body given by Maya. This is the Mayavad philosophy. But actually, Krishna does not come because Krishna says, the idhesa gunami mama maya. Maya is controlled by him. How he can accept subordinates of Maya? No. The Vaishnava philosophy is very perfect philosophy according to the Shastra and Vedas. All the acharyas conform. So we have to follow this. Then our life will be successful. So Krishna is teaching how to work. How to work. Now here he says, the tatya karma phala. Now who will be ready to work? Suppose you are doing some business and there is expectation of profit, 1 lakh of rupees. Now profit comes. Then, if I say now, here is in Bhagavad Gita, it is a tatya karma phala. You give it up. Are you ready? No. I have heard with so much heart, never have earned. Why shall I give it up? But here it is said, tatya karma phala. Then immediately his impetus to work will be finished. That this ordinary person, those who are enkurmis, if I say that yes, you earn lakhs of rupees, but you will not be allowed to take it. Just like the communist country. The communist country, they're engaging people to work. But you cannot take the result, the government is there. Therefore, they are not very enthusiastic. I have been in a communist country. They are not very enthusiastic. That is, unless one can enjoy personally, is not interested in any business. Why shall I work so hard? This is nature. But here it is said, tatta karma phala. What is the difference between the communist philosophy and Vaishnava philosophy? The communists also say that everyone should work without expecting the result. The result will go to the government. But similarly, where the result will go, it is communist proposal. No. Tatta karma phala means that you should give it to Krishna. That is tatta karma. So those who are devoted, although tatta karma phalam, they are not touching the fruit, still they are nitya tripta, very satisfied. The karmis are dissatisfied. So I have hard, worked so hard, now I have to give up whatever I have earned. He becomes very, very sorry. But who becomes nitya tripta? Working like this, without taking the result, is still nitya tripta. Very satisfied. That is devotee. That is devotee. You see, these boys, these European boys, also some of them are Indian, they are working day and night. They are getting money also. They are making life members. They are selling some books. There is no scarcity of money. But they do not touch even single pie. It is for Krishna. And still they are happy. This is tatta karma phalam. Asanga. Asanga means no attachment. They are bringing money and giving to me. I spend like anything. So this is tatta karma phalam. Asanga. Nitya tripta, very much satisfied. I have been able to collect so much and give it to Krishna. This is their satisfaction. Takta karma phalam asanga nitya nirashaya. Don't expect any profit. No dividend. As soon as there is dividend, immediately it is material. Immediately it is complicated. And so long there is no expectation of dividend, then it is pure devotee. This is the difference. Anna vilasita sudnam jnana karma dhanabhitam. Jnana karma dhanabhitam. This karma fall. A devotee doesn't want karma fall. Therefore he is not implicated. He doesn't want. Therefore it is said, karma, karmani abhipravittopi. Although he is engaged in karma, because superficially it looks like karma. Karma and bhakti looks the same thing. But the difference is that the result is for Krishna and the karmis result is for myself. That is the difference. That is the difference. Karmani abhipravittopi naiva kinchit karoti sa. This is the... although he is doing day and night, but he is still doing nothing. Doing nothing when he is doing, but he is not becoming entangled with the results. That is because karma and karma fall. One has to accept the karma fall. But this man who is doing everything for Krishna, he is not becoming entangled. That is explained in the second chapter also. Jagnyate karma, annatra karma bandhana. If you don't act for Krishna, then you will be entangled by the resultant action. But if you do it for Krishna, then you will not be entangled. Everything will be taken as devotion. Everything will be taken on account of devotion. And devotion means you are making progress. Mancha bhavicharini bhakti yogi na jasevate Sagunan samatittainan brahma bhuyaya kalpati. So activities are the platform of devotional service without expecting any result for his personal satisfaction means on the platform of liberation. Thank you very much.